Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I want to thank you as well for being here today. It took tremendous courage. I'm not sure how many people fully realize the burden on survivors in America to come forward and recall what happened to them. It is, in a sense, not just recalling the trauma and the violence and the pain, but it is, as you all well know, being forced to relive it. And for that, I'm deeply grateful that you would sit here in a room of strangers in front of powerful people and again relive that trauma. And I also know you didn't come here for our kind words or our proudness or our empathy. You came here for justice. You came here for action. You've heard words literally for years, and you're still fighting. You're fighting against a systemic problem in our country that isn't just in sports. We've seen it from church institutions to the Boy Scouts. When you talk about pedophilia all the way to sexual assault, we see it in diners, workplaces, factory floors. And you all as athletes are doing something in a tradition that is, to me, what has helped to call the conscience of our country forward and expand our moral imagination to stop injustices of other sorts, from people who endured outrageous realities like Billie Jean King, who used their platforms not to try to get individual attention, but to try to change this nation and make it more just. And so I'm grateful that we are at a point where we have such bipartisan determination in this town. It's not often enough, but here we have bipartisan determination of some of my most respected colleagues to deliver what you really came for, which is action. I say that to tell you also that we all know that the road to change, real change, systemic change, not just in sport, but in our culture, that seems to tolerate such a high level of this sort of violence, that is going to take time. And there's one saying that always rings in my head, that the only thing necessary for injustice to continue is for good people to do nothing. And you all have seen that firsthand. And so I've heard you before be asked the question by media to even in this institution today, you asked the question, do you have any words for other survivors? I would like to simply ask the question of you to answer, to put the point and the light where it belongs. It shouldn't take something directly happening to us to trigger our empathy and our action. And maybe I would like to know if you have any words for Americans who amidst a country where this violence happens every single day. Is there something you'd like to say to us who all have to understand that we are playing a part in a culture that allows this to happen?
I would like to say that I personally don't think that people realize how much experiencing a type of abuse is not something that one just suffers in the moment. It carries on with them sometimes for the rest of their lives. For example, being here today is taking everything I have. My main concern is I hope I have the energy even to just walk out of here. I don't think people realize how much it affects us, how much the PTSD, how much the trauma impacts us, and for every survivor it's different. Healing looks different for every survivor. The aftermath looks very different. For me, just to paint a picture, I used to train some days 7 hours a day when I was training for the Olympics, and processing my abuse affected me so much, and it is still something I struggle with, that I can remember when I first shared my story publicly for a very, very long time, I didn't even have the energy to stand up in the shower. I would have to sit on the floor and wash my hair because standing up was too exhausting for me. I couldn't even go for a 10-minute walk outside. And this is someone I've competed in 2 Olympic Games. And there are times where I feel like I forget what I'm saying. I feel like my mind isn't working. I feel like I have no energy at all. I'm 27 years old, and my 80-year-old grandfather has more energy than I do. And I've often wondered, am I ever gonna feel better? And it has affected my health. In the last couple of years, I've had to be taken in an ambulance because I pass out, and I'm so sick from just the trauma. And it might not even be after a hearing like this. It just hits me out of the blue. And so I think it's important for people to understand how much, you know, even if we're not crying, how much we are all struggling and how much survivors are suffering. Because people often say, well, why did you just come forward now? Because it's terrifying to come forward, the fear of not being believed, but also because it affects us so much, and sometimes it's impossible just to say the words out loud. And so I just want people to know, and I'm sure for a lot of us, especially myself, like, this might take me months to recover. And so I just wanted to make that clear, because I think it's important for people to start recognizing, you may never know what someone else is going through, but for people who have been through trauma, it's really hard. And if someone's watching this that is feeling really tired, that is a survivor and doesn't know why they're having certain issues that are new, just know that that you're not alone. And I experienced the same thing. And hopefully, in time, we can feel better.
Thank you, Senator Booker.